Snorkel, the performing beast. Every morning in the street market, Cyril Snorkel would ring a bell and cry,
I'm Cyril Snorkel, the performing beast. Swallowing swords for me is a feast. I can juggle and walk the tightrope too. Roll up, roll up, I'll entertain you.
First he would stand on a football and juggle a dozen partridge eggs. Then he walked the tightrope, balancing a jug of lemon juice on his nose. And once a week, he would do the dangerous trick of swallowing a sword. To end his show, he whizzed about on roller skates, playing a tune on a brass trumpet. The crowd clapped wildly. How they all loved the performing beast! Then Cyril would bow, and everyone threw money into his shiny satin hat. But in the afternoons, when Cyril went home, he sat there all alone. And every evening, he ate dinner all by himself.
No one wants to visit a beast, he sighed. They only want me to entertain them.
Cyril Snorkel felt very lonely. One day, Princess Amanda came to the market. She too enjoyed watching Cyril Snorkel, the performing beast. After Cyril's show, the princess shook his hand.
You are so daring, she said. Thank you for the show.
At home that evening, Cyril felt very happy.
What a smashing princess, he thought. And she spoke so kindly to me.
Every day, Cyril performed in the market, hoping the kind princess would return. But alas, she never came. Then, one day, a messenger delivered a scroll inviting Cyril to give a royal performance that night at the palace ball. Cyril was delighted.
Hooray! She remembers me,
he said, and packed and went home to rehearse his show. That evening at the ball, amidst a fanfare of trumpets, the king announced,
Here is Cyril Snorkel, the performing beast.
Cyril juggled, walked the tightrope, and did his fire-eating trick. The guests clapped loudly, especially the princess. After thanking Cyril, the king said,
I offer Amanda's hand in marriage to any bachelor who can wear this magic ring.
The princess waved sadly to Cyril. He sat in a corner while a crowd of men fought to try on the ring. But as each man had a go at wearing the magic ring, it turned red hot and he had to fling it off, yelling in pain. The last man flung the ring so hard that it landed high up on the chandelier.
I'll fetch it,
said Cyril, hopefully.
It'll burn your fingers,
laughed the guests. But Cyril leapt up with a mighty spring and plucked the ring off. Wearing the magic ring, he landed safely.
Cyril can wear the ring, cried the king. Arrange the marriage.
Amanda kissed Cyril's snout and said, We'll be together forever.
ever.
The guests clapped and congratulated them. Happily married to Amanda, Cyril was never lonely. He taught her tricks, and once a week, they performed for the king.